Hey there. In this episode, you are going to see a healing with Rini York. And in Rini's session, we dove into it, kind of looking for clearing some ascension stuff that she was feeling blocked and things were not really working out. She felt like there was some old stuff being triggered about being broken. And so what's interesting that you're going to find out is that as soon as we open up the session, we actually start working on entirely different things, like different energies and entities that were just kind of looming around. So you're going to want to tune in all the way till the end as well so that you can hear how Rini felt at the end of the session. And more importantly, a couple weeks later. That's what we've been doing this entire series. So if this is the first of the series that you're watching, check out the rest in this series. And make sure you do watch to the end, because all of the clients have sent in a video essentially saying how life has shifted for them a week or two later, which I think is even more powerful, because when we're doing energy healing work, we have this huge energy shift. And then, of course, you go back to your daily life. So what we want to see is how energy is impacting the rest of their life. So if you haven't watched, go ahead and catch up on them all here. And let's get into Rini's session right away. Okay, now we're on. So, Rini, this is part of a series, which I think you know about, but I think we've got, you're number five of the series. So we are basically meeting, we've met before, we've done these sessions before, yeah, but it's been a while. So basically, I want to dive right in. And for the people who are watching, if this is the first episode you watched, make sure to check out the series because there's a whole bunch of other ones in there as well. So let's dive right in. So is there anything that you wanted to work on today?
I'm definitely going through like a whole new level of transformation. Mm-hmm. And I feel like it's definitely linked with my business. And it's definitely stems from like old beliefs. The one that's been really present is one of being broken. Mm-hmm. That's been a huge one, and mm-hmm. really needing to like shift that on a, you know, like, I feel like I've shifted that on many surface levels. Well, even through your program and all of that, like really, you know, shifting my self-worth, but I think that belief is still kind of entrenched in there.
Yeah. Well, it's funny when you said it sent a chill through my body and I still feel it. Like everything is kind of like lit up and like tingly. It's interesting because I did have a little bit of a sense that things might be shifting in that way. We had like a quick little card session a couple weeks ago, which was like fun and random. So I got to kind of see you then. But then before the session started, I pulled some cards and I was feeling into your energy. This little fluorite crystal wanted to work with you.
Nice.
I love fluorite.
I do too.
And then you got these three cards. Number one was branding. You're a unique snowflake, which signaled to me like change is happening. And so I was like, oh, I don't know what's going on, but that's great. But what also came up was really around a little bit of like instability with that change happening. And I get it. When things change, it can be scary. You know, it's like good things, we want it, but it usually shakes up everything else. And it creates a little bit of disharmony as things are shifting. So the second card was flow, let go of control.
Yes.
We all know what that means.
Yeah.
No further explanation needed.
Probably. Yep. I was just talking about that yesterday. I'm like, I'm really feeling like things are not flowing. Like, yeah.
And then the third card is gratitude. Give thanks for all you have. So what these are kind of signaling to me as we get started is the tide is changing. Things are changing. You're changing. You are evolving. There's new things that are coming up. But part of the work to do that next level of stuff is letting go of your grip of how you think it should be. And like if I could count the times that I've had to stop controlling things, I mean, from when I started working in my brick and mortar and shifting into online, and then from online into like single sessions and then to group and then to programs and then to mastermind, like all the different like iterations of how the business grew, it forced me to stop following what I knew.
Yeah.
And when you do that, you can tap into your higher self. And you can tap into your knowing, and you can tap into your wisdom. And if there is one thing I know that'd be true about you, Rini, is you got some knowledge. You've got some wisdom. You've got decades baked in and beyond. Like you've accessed higher realms, and you know how to do this work. And so this is really a matter of being kind of squeezed and pushed through to really start like walking the walk on a deeper level. And it's a good thing, because when you can really embody that and you can start using deeper and you can access deeper levels of intuition, and then you start to deliver from a different place as well. And the gratitude piece, what that was signaling is like, things have always worked out.
Yeah, it's true.
And that's another thing I know about you is things always work out, even if it feels unsteady or strange. Like weird, crazy, awesome things are like constantly happening for you.
Yeah.
Like I remember when you got like a car, I was like, oh, I just happened to get a new car. It just fell into my lap.
Well, yeah, literally two other cars fell into my lap. Just like literally coming in 2 weeks. Yeah.
Please file this under shit that just doesn't happen to most people.
Right. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. And so it's like, there is so much always happening in that way for you, and work is there. And like, you know, as we shift and transition, there is like this little, I'm hearing the word ravine. That's a little extreme. It's not a ravine. It's not a ravine. It's just like the sacred pause. Let's just like, let's put some sweetness on that. It's a little sacred pause. It might feel like a ravine though to you.
Right. Yeah.
So if it feels like a ravine, like I get it. I mean, I personally have just gone through it and like sort of just like kind of out of that. But when those things happen, when we shift and pivot, we start to open and access different places in ourselves. Yeah. It disrupts things and it can be scary. And then also we have to lean in like, okay, it's always worked out. It's always going to work out. It's working out fine. It's better than fine.
Yeah.
Excuse me. There's like a huge shift. It's better than fine.
Yeah.
So I know that, like you said, there's a transition. There's a new level. And so I definitely think that it's going to be great to explore this so that you can let this new thing come out of you in this whole new way. You know, we want you to be able to innovate what you do, how you do it, who you do it for. You don't have to stick with the recipe that's been working. You can innovate and change it up. And hell, like maybe you used to make bread, but not gonna make bread anymore. We're making hummus. We're making like something utterly, entirely different with different ingredients altogether. So I feel like that wants to come in for you and open up some new possibilities. Anything else? How have you been feeling physically?
Not good. Like really. So there's a couple things that I feel like kind of got me, like knocked me off. I felt like was like COVID. Mm-hmm. I had like 105 fever. 103 fever for like a few days. Oh. And then it just feels like it's lingered. And I'm trying to like, even like now how I talk about it, I'm trying to like, be like, okay, I just need some rest today. Versus like, I'm depleted, I'm exhausted, you know, all of that. Yeah. And I'm also, just trying to like allow the rest as integration time. But I would say, like, in the past few weeks, that's been challenging because I've been like, oh my God, why is this like this? You know?
Yeah. Was that recently that you had it?
Yeah, I got it. I actually got it like a day and a half after we got the puppies, which is like, you know, not ideal for my husband and I to both be out with COVID with two new puppies. Every 2 hours. And we got them young. They were like 5.5 weeks. So they were like, you know, yeah, bottle feeding. Yeah. So I think like that, after the whole moving and all of that, just kind of compiled. So I'm like, I guess I'm like in a deep pause, you know?
Yes. Yeah.
So I'm trying to like start and move forward on like the membership and things like that. But then on the other side, my body's like, pause. Like, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And
so there's a struggle there.
Yeah, I hear it. I hear it. Yeah. And when I had it in January, it took me out, and it's same thing, that lingering. It's the lingering. Mm-hmm. It's just the stink that doesn't leave the air. It's like, yeah, it's just there. And something very magical does also happen there with that pause and that rest. And I will say that I too was a little bit like ready to get going again and like move and do things. And I couldn't. So if you can stop resisting the rest, what does that feel like for you? If you can stop resisting that.
I mean, it feels like relief on one hand to stop resisting it. And then I think like the old patterns of like money stuff kind of come in, because like literally the day, well, so my daughter got COVID on my birthday and we overdrew our account on the same day. So it was kind of like getting knocked off, but then the need to work felt stronger.
Yeah.
So that was the sticking point.
Yeah, I gotcha. Okay. So, and it's also this membership wants to come in to give you more passive income so that you don't have to work so hard for the thing.
Exactly.
Okay. Yeah. Got it. All right. So let's sit with that. So, what's interesting is that the rest will give you the space for that membership to like really come in and come together. Mm. If we allow it to as well. So sometime it was the exact day, was when I felt my absolute worst. And I was just like, come on already. I was just like, enough with this.
Yeah.
And like, I need to do things. And that night I was feeling grief. I was feeling anger. Like all of these things were coming up to the surface, and here we are at a new moon. Like,
yes,
exact minute.
Moment. Yeah.
When would you like to do the session? Right this time. As the moon crosses over.
Yeah.
I mean, we're here for a reason, you know, this is what we're here. We're drawing up this shadowy stuff and being able to really address it in a deeper level so that this next level can just come busting out of you. And I get a chill as I say that. So that's great. So let's do some work and just sort of see what shows up. You know what wants to come in is this Lemurian quartz. Ooh, we're going to do some fun stuff.
I felt that too.
Well, this crystal, she's like, we're not messing around today. Okay. All right. So I'm going to take these off. Sometimes it's like just too much. All right. Whew. Let's get this party started. All right. I call in this the highest, most crystalline, pure white healing light filled with the highest healing vibrations, and I ask for this light to surround the space, sealing it as a sacred healing space for Rini, allowing her to receive everything she requires from this session. I ask for this light to fill her body, filling every cell, every molecule, opening her up for her next level of ascension, of growth, of wisdom, of passion, of joy. Allowing Rini to trust in her instincts, to follow her wisdom, and to be able to manifest all her true heart's desires in this lifetime. Feeling expansion, able to open up that next level of financial abundance. We call in all of her highest guidance, her highest angels and archangels to be present with us. Started opening up, there was this word that came in and now it's gone. What is the word again? I can't think of what the word is, but it's moved. But basically I wanted to ask you if you've been working with other, not entities, but like other like, are you working with other forms, other energy?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes. Very strongly.
Okay.
I've been doing a magic mentorship with somebody. So I've been really tapping into star wisdom, but also other deities and like primal energies.
Okay. Yeah. That was like, as soon as I started to hold the space, it was like, I don't even know what, I don't have a word. Like it came in and it left and right. I can't get it again.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's significant. So part of this too, it's like, I mean, you obviously know this, and I'm sure whatever this program is covers it too, but we need to be very mindful of holding the sacred space for ourselves, especially when doing healing work, when we're opening up, because right. You know, I mean, listen, I don't know what the truth is behind it. I'm just gonna say that, but there are rumors that other energies, other entities have been infiltrated by dark forces,
right.
Energies. And right. So like, we have to always be mindful of how we set our space and who we call in and how we work with these energies. So why did that need to come in? I mean, we don't have to go in and talk about it, but like, are you towing the line? Like, is there like it's not, you said magic, what, like, I don't know how to even say this question. It's not coming out.
Right. I mean, I'm working with fixed star energies. So learning about the energies of the fixed stars, kind of tapping, kind of like traveling to them.
Okay.
Learning about them.
Okay.
It's very like, clear in the light though. Like it's not,
okay,
towing in the, you okay. know, to the darkness at all. It's very like, very good, like boundaries with darkness and, you know what I mean?
Okay.
That aspect. But it is also,
okay. So what it is it's almost like this little vacuum of light, and it's almost like these little things are kind of like following you, and then calling you back down. So, I'm just going to remove any entities or any things that are in your field or accessing or drawing in your energy, whether you've given.
Well, it's interesting you say that, because there's like my husband, and he's the only one that feels like he feels. So in our room, when he looks out the window, he feels angry and irritable and upset. And so, and we feel like that's something, like even the previous owner here had got like suddenly like got liver, I don't know, sick. I think she needed a transplant, but I was like, oh, that's interesting. Cause that's like in Chinese medicine, that's like anger, irritability. That's what that is. And I was like, I feel like that's a thing that is definitely like trying to attach to him very much. Mm. And so it's definitely in affecting me.
Yeah.
Through him.
Yeah. Got it. Okay. Yeah. I'm getting a hit on that too. So, I mean, it's coming up for a reason. So I'll just check into the energy of your home while we're there.
I am.
Because if your husband is getting affected by it, and he's very sensitive as well. Are you still using your sacred geometry around the house?
I am, but I haven't in that, like on that side, on that wall, I haven't. So that would be good.
Yeah. Yeah. I almost feel like I'm getting an image of Ghostbusters right now.
Yeah,
of
yeah.
Like, let's give them all we got. And yeah. So I want to be able to seal your house and your space and the vicinity. Also, like, here's something that you could try. There's a website. I'm not an affiliate in any way, although I should be, because now I talk about this thing is ridiculous. It's called FLFE, Focus Life Force Energy. And you can literally send high consciousness energy to a physical location or to a mobile device.
Oh, wow.
It's cool. Freaking awesome. And you can do a 2-week free trial. I swear to God, I'm not an advertiser.
No, that's great. I love that.
So FLFE.net. And I feel so silly because I know it's going to be just, anyway. Try it out and see, do the trial and see how that shifts for him, for you, your home.
Yeah.
That can be something. I just want to tap in a little bit. So I'm going to anchor in a bit. Really want to open up. Let's just open up that space again. Surround the house with this beautiful white healing light, releasing anything that doesn't serve you, your family, all the inhabitants of your home, clear completely. Release anything that doesn't serve you, the home, the land. This little vacuum, it's cleaning up around the house. So let's just vacuum up anything else. They're saying get a blue crystal. And my blue crystals. This is kyanite.
Oh, I love kyanite.
I do too. And just as we open this up, like a beam of sunlight came into my skylight as well. So there's an extra energy of light coming in. Bring those light codes in, light activation around your property, your land. Transmute, release, delete. Anything that doesn't serve you. Your husband, your kids, your dogs, and any family members. They're bringing me back to that like stream. It was almost like a comet kind of following you, trailing. So it's clear through all space, time, and dimensions. Anything it might be following, trailing, or otherwise trying to access your energy field, light, or the work that you're doing. Because it is, it's so nice working in other spaces and realms and dimensions. It's so nice to get out of our physical body for a change and just like stretch our legs, so to speak, our spirit soul legs. But it's like, we also need to be really tethered and grounded here. Sometimes when I'm doing high level ascension work, I do hold on to a crystal as that like physical touchy thing to like, I'm here. See, I have a hand and I'm holding my hand and there's things. So if there's, you know, crystal, mineral object, something that you can put in your lap or in your hand.
I think that's great.
Just keep, remind your physical body to come back in. Reclaiming any parts of you that have been let go of. Access. It's like access deny. Access deny. They wanted me to ask you, are you ready to release and revoke all access to any energies or entities that have access to your energy field, knowingly or unknowingly by you?
Yes.
Okay, let's go. Yeah. Okay, and we're back. Good. So it's like the energy just went, okay. Beautiful.
Yeah, I felt it.
It's still sending like ripples. That's great. Okay. Now where do we want to go? All right, let's go into your field again. Feels much, much lighter. Now that energy of the fluorite was ready to come in. It's like it needed something a little bit stronger. Okay. Let's just open that up, clearing. Let's open up your crown. Good. Really expansion. Now it's like, now your third eye is like, woo! It's like open. Yes. Good. I feel happy for your third eye. And you know, part of that heaviness that COVID brought, like the energies that are around you too, it's like they're all kind of like conspiring, like, yeah. Now we've got them out, so let's, now we can like lift you back up. And you know, it's like your spirit team is like acknowledging you. It's like we're trying to do the best we can. And if you've been really working on your meditation practice and focus, like it's not your fault, you haven't done anything wrong. It's just like other stuff has been going on around you. So crown feels great, third eye feels awesome. Keep going in. What was that belief around being broken? So let's go up to that place about being broken. So where do you feel that when you bring that up about that old belief about being broken?
I feel it like throat and root.
Okay, so let's go into that. The feeling I'm getting in throat isn't so deeply around the broken. It's more of expectations from other people. And I'm feeling specifically like a dad, like little dad chord in the throat of like, like, what are you doing with yourself, with your life? So let's just open up to that and clear that. Because honestly, you're one of the most impressive women I've ever met. And selfishly, I'm like, I will fight you. Come on, come at me. Listen, bud. So let's just open that up. You mess with my friends. Don't. All right, let's open that up. Clear me. And this opening of is pulling in your sovereignty. It's like, yes, coming and reclaiming your own power, your own voice, your own message. Oh, huge opening. And this is also allowing you to call in that next level of clients to you who are ready for this work. Because dang, like the planet needs you, the planet needs your message, and we need your work. People who are out there needing this are ready for it. So it's open through your throat, really allowing you to speak your truth. Listen through all lifetimes. Whew. Huge, huge openings. Let's really root that, good release. Root that right into the throat, right into the spinal column. Yes, good. Bring more light and energy in, feeling that through heart. Upgrade. There's something that you're doing for $20. Is something you're doing for $20?
I offered the grab bags for $20, just around the holidays.
Okay. Well, whatever it is, no more. Please don't do anything else for $20. It's like, I don't know why it just came up like real strong of like $20 new. So, if you're considering something, no. So,
Yeah, it's interesting. I was actually considering something. Okay. All right.
Thank you for that confirmation. Whatever it is, it's a no.
Okay. Good to know.
I don't even say it on here. I love it. Oh my gosh. And that's in your heart's chakra. This is about giving and receiving unconditional love. It's like, you are so much more valuable than this $20. It's a no. Listen, do you even know who you are? That is some like broke ass shit. That is not you. So that's why it needs to come up. And I'm apparently yelling at you about it. So I'm very passionate for you to not do that. I don't even know what it is, and I'm defending your honor again. So let's just clear that out. Mm-mm. Because as fast as you might be able to say those $20 things can work, yeah, it can also be just as fast if it were $120. Okay. And I know me, like I have worked with you, and I send you another $100 after a session with you. You didn't charge me enough. I was like, listen, I need this work to work. So I'm going to just give you some extra dough.
Yeah.
I don't do that frequently, but this is, it is like, and I mean it with all sincerity, is like, you could sell them as fast at 120. And trust me, I've had clients who like look at me sideways and they're like, if it's not selling at 20, what in God's name would you be, crazy bitch? Like, why would I raise my rates that much? And then when they do, oh my God, they get booked out. They get repeat clients. They get new ideas. They get new programs. They get these like crazy things that start to show up for them because they were able to say yes. And then by saying yes, they could access more.
Right.
And so that's the tone of this session, of like, upgrade you.
Right.
And like I said, is like no longer doing the things that we used to do because they're keeping us in this perpetual holding pattern.
Right. And to let you know, you're the third person in a week that told me to raise my prices.
Throw something at you now. Apparently she needs to be yelled at three times. Apparently. You are no longer who you were.
Right.
You've crossed the bridge. You've made the leap. You are not who you used to be.
Right.
And you have to accept that. So this is where you need to accept it. Like, think about it. You need 10 of them at $20 for one of them. Right. More isn't better.
Right.
Better is better. Because the person who says yes at 120 values you, loves you, honors you, refers people to you. And and I can speak on a personal level because I've received your magic and you, like the things that you've said to me are still resonate. And it was, I don't even know how long ago it was, but I'll probably get another session. If you're at 120, I'll pay all day, all day. So this is about really, truly accepting this shift in your heart and letting go of the past you with love. She got you here. And damn, she's put in a lot of work, a lot of energy, blood, sweat, and tears, all of it to get you where you are. And it's not a letting go of and like burning down what became before. It is an honor. You're honoring who you used to be by raising your rates. You're honoring the path that you've been on. And so really feel that expansion in your heart and feel all those colors and those nutrients and those minerals and all those, but like crystalline energy coming into your heart to really formulate a beautiful, strong boundary and bringing that energy even stronger for your heart so that you can give from a bigger, deeper, more impactful place. Now we're open up to new dimensions. You feel that shift when you say yes to yourself. Yeah, you can really, truly open up. See, they know. Right on cue. You make it up, man. Get it, Mom. We know that sound is energy too. We know that every sound is part of the session too, that they're part of the healing. They're part of this expansion. It's not a distraction for anybody. It's seriously part of this healing. We need to move the energy. They're like forcefully moving energy from your heart chakra. And I don't know any other animal that unconditionally loves anybody like a dog, but like, That's what they're bringing for you too. It's like, oh, thank you. I thank animals when they show up for sessions. So what a gift that your dogs just gave you of really helping you to like, wow, I almost just threw the crystal, move that energy in your heart, really accept that. And, you know, something I did the other day, which actually was hard for me, was I started to calculate the hours of experience that I had. Rini, for a split second, can you even wrap your head around calculating the hours of experience you have? The hours of training, the hours of practical, the hours of clinic sessions, the books, the programs, the certifications, the tens of thousands of clients that you have worked on. I would like to give you some homework. This would be just like from me to you, a little fun activity when you have some spare time, when you're not resting and integrating. Because what happens is you actually see black and white, oh my gosh, thousands and thousands and thousands of hours. You are beyond worthy. And so this is where your heart is like, I'm trying to sing a new song here, I'm opening up. So let's just allow that. It's like this real beautiful rainbowy colors coming in, this new level, new dimensions. Because there is a connection that you can bring in stars into this. There is this expansion of how, like, this multidimensionality that's wanting to come in for your work. It's not just but up. It is like, you know, now the guides are playing. So my son, we were at like a secondhand toy store, and she's like, "Mom, watch the magic." And it's this toy, and it goes like this. You know, it's like a ball that expands, and that's what they just showed me. It's like, it looks like this, but it's actually like that. That's your work. It's so much. And it's almost like you can speak to the planets and the stars to get further information for bringing it in into a more digestible way. It's so personalized. Are you doing more with your astrology? Yes, that's your membership. Oh, wait, you're on mute. You're on mute now. Dang it.
Oh, sorry. So my membership is astrology based, and it's about tuning into your divine wisdom, like your celestial wisdom. Like teaching people how to do that for themselves. But I'm also, after that, bringing in a training for coaches and healers of how to do that for their clients.
Cool.
Yeah. So
perfect. Because what it's showing me is like, I'm seeing you like in the ethers, like, like feeling in where, I'm gonna sound so stupid, feeling in like, where is Pluto and this star and how are they talking to each other? What's going on over here? And like, what's coming? And like, it's like you're in the chart.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, and so it's interesting because I was like, you know, people have said, you do it so differently. I'm like, what am I doing that's different? Because I do know that what I'm doing is different and I've been trying to figure out what it is. And I was like, because I've combined the quantum healing that I've done through the chart of astrology. And so it's not just reading the chart. It is a healing session of like seeing yourself through these eyes of spirit, but it's like through the lens of the planets. So I was like, oh, like quantum healing astrology. That's what this is.
Yes. Look at you. You're like,
yeah.
Yes. And see, like that needs to come out of you.
Right.
It's been, I don't know how long it's been haunting you for, but it's here. And yeah. she needs that space. She needs to be able to stretch out and show off and express herself. And she needs to feel divine. She needs to feel divine. Mm-hmm. And sign me up for that. It sounds awesome. I'll be your beta member.
Awesome.
On record. Oh my God. Okay. So there's a lot in here that's wanting to really expand. Is there anything else? No, this yummy, like mandarin citrus smell is coming in. Whew, I love that. It's like a breath of sunshine.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so let's continue going down to solar. We are replacing solar immediately. It's like she's not even there. She's gone somewhere else. We've blown out. So we've got to open up the next level solar plexus to come in. We're just bringing it nice and slowly. Just recalling your power, reclaiming your birthright. Allow allowing that vision to develop, but also trusting in its timing. There, as your third chakra is coming in, they're showing me like, you know, a time lapse of like gestational, like as an embryo is crawling. Let's grow into that. It's sort of also simultaneously doing some healing from you from when you were in that early stage of life coming in. Interesting, because I know we're in third, but it's kind of into second chakra as well. So we're kind of into both right now. It's like a little in-betweener. Ooh, excuse me, there's a huge shift there to open up through third. There you go. Just slowly showing like a flower starting to open up slowly, petal by petal. It's showing me looking at like a stargazer lily. Mm-hmm. And you know, those are so fragrant and so just like you can smell them as soon as you open a door. If somebody has them in their house, they're like, whoo. So let's just bring the aromatics and the beauty and the softness of that white crisp petal, the beautiful little colors of red and orange. Little pollinator bees coming in with it. And so that pollinator bee is really interesting because it's really signaling that joyful worker bee and not having to work so hard, because I think that's where, if you have felt depleted with overworking, that's where it's hitting you in your solar plexus. That causes you to self-doubt, which is probably only making it worse to want to work harder. Like, is this working? I don't know. And so like, I have to work harder. But like, when we think of this beautiful stargazer lily with this happy little buzzy bee around it, like it's got a seasonality, it's got a cycle, it doesn't, can't pollinate when the petals are closed or at nighttime. Like, it's seasonally, so we have to be really respectful. This new level of respect, I mean, this divine feminine, whoo, she's like serving up some information for you. Cycles, right? We have to respect the cycle that you're in. I don't need a lecture you want on this. I'm not going to. But this beautiful worker bee of like, it's part of a collaborative. It's part of a higher level. And you're needing to, again, back up to third, heart chakra is like acknowledging this higher level of consciousness that is allowing this work to come through you. It's needing the work to come through you. Listen, we are being called. We are being called to bring a higher level of consciousness to the planet. And you are part of a collaborative of light workers. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, you are part of a collaborative of light workers who need to bring this work and this light into the planet right now. Do you accept?
Yes.
Okay. There she is. Good. And we're rooted. Good. Let's go down to second. Going into sacral chakra. And I'm actually asking around, like, are there broken pieces? Any resonance of brokenness? No, it was that mistrusting and that blowing out the third chakra. So let's go into second. Really open up that new cycles of creativity, womb wisdom. Really nurturing your own cycles of creativity and soul expression. You might want to hire an artist who can put a visual representation to the work that you're bringing in, whether it be like infographics or just creative things around sharing your work on Instagram and your membership, like somebody who really gets what you do. And they're saying it's okay if it needs to be a swap for right now, it's okay. But you also need to make sure that swap is at the appropriate price point, that it's not like, these are the bargain basement prices. And I would like, you know, it needs to be a fair, it needs to be a fair exchange where, and I feel like it could be like a young graphic designer who's really like geeks out about this work that you're doing, and it can be like mutually beneficial for you to work together.
Right.
Yeah. Like a young woman, really, and I feel like she can really grow with you, even for the next like 9 months to a year, that she can really be with you to get this off of the ground, mm-hmm. and help to really solidify this brand, solidify this message, your own belief in yourself, because I feel like part of that third chakra, it needs your creative energy. But like, listen, I am no graphics specialist. And when I try, it's okay. And I've gotten better over the years, but like, that's not my wheelhouse and it's not yours. Right. And it's not an insult to what you ever you've made. Totally. It's just simply saying like, it can be elevated. And when you see your work elevated at that like artistic level, it's going to be like, oh shit, that's who I am. And it's going to click for you. And it might inspire you to do like a photo shoot or like having colors. Like one of my clients and friends, Mary, she's been using people's astrological charts to do like branding colors.
I saw that. Yeah.
And I've seen some other people she did, and I'm like, holy hell, like that's on point. So like, I don't know, maybe you can reach out to her for like some color guides.
Right.
But either way, like, I just feel like this next level artistry is ready to come in and you are ready for it. So either seek it out or call it in, but like there's a little bit of like partnery kind of energy with the images that want to come in for you.
Cool.
And that is also going to help really build trust with your soulmate clients of how they can really see you in your work. Finally, I would say again, mm-hmm. but it's finally, And that trust is like really just also adding to the professionalism and like just so much. It's just going to bring it. It's going to elevate you and your work so, so much. And it's like deliberate. Like I'm doing this deliberately to raise this vibration, to raise the consciousness. I just asked, do I have to say that? They said, yes. You owe it to the collective.
Hmm.
And this is not like some spiritual guilt trip crap, but it's like, you came here to do something. And like, maybe you were also sent here to do something. So we need you. The collective needs you. And and it's like, I feel, I'm in second chakra still. It's like, I feel like I can get lost in myself sometimes. I feel like I can get lost. And, I resonate with that, Rini. I so do. And when we feel lost and we feel like, I can't do this. Who am I to even do this? These are just our thoughts. These are just our feelings. This is just this human experience that we're living. Because even it's almost like as soon as the thought comes in, there is like this little whisper that's like, you're different. And, Don't allow yourself to get lost in that, because they're just thoughts and they're bullshit.
Right.
And, you know, if if there's ever a time where those thoughts like consume you and you're feeling lost, you got to come back. Got to come back. How do we need to bring her back? Your family. Your husband. Does he know about like your mission here on the planet?
I mean, I think he knows that I'm on my path of bringing it out and that it's very spiritual and healing. But it's interesting you ask that because that's what got me stuck in it. We got in a fight and that's what I got lost in was like all the things he said to me that he didn't mean, but he said them. And so totally where I got lost.
Yeah. I've had those conversations myself. But there's an interest in that thing that can happen that, and you know it, it's like, you can get to this crossroads where you're like, I can't tolerate this anymore. And I think that part of the conversation can be elevated when you now can be honest with yourself as this heart has expanded, as you're being embodied to do this work, is vocalize that change. Because on the outside, like when you open that door and you go back out to your life, you look like the same person. But you didn't change. You're still Rini. You're still the same blue sweater on. It's still you. But it's actually not, because when you've embodied your higher self and you've accepted this mission, tolerance for some other conversations gets diminished.
Right.
And as soon as we really embody that path, I know I had to have a hard conversation with my husband. I was like, listen, this train is on a track and it is moving. You either hop on or you get out of the way.
Yeah.
And I think that can be very harsh for some people.
Yeah.
But that was the image that I got. It was like, I can't stop this.
Right.
I'm on a mission and I'm here to help millions of people. So like, if you're going to try to slow me down or stop me, like, good luck. I dare you. I'm here. I'm on a mission. And I might not be helping millions of people today, but what I'm doing is going to affect people. And it's on this path. This is where I know I need to be because I've never felt better. I never felt stronger. I never felt more sure of anything.
Right.
But when I have these conversations on the sidebar and they make me doubt my shit, that can't fly, because it takes me, slowing down that progression. And you've worked too dang hard to get to where you are to have to like pump the brakes every so often.
Right.
And so, it's like, it's out of love to have this conversation to say, listen, I'm here to do some really big things and I can't afford to get lost, to lose myself and to forget again. And I need you to help me remember. I need you to help me stay on my path. And that can shift. Like, it can give him a job. All right. Keeping you on the straight and narrow. Got you. Love you, boo. And I know my husband has a miracle happen. And now that's exactly what he does. If I'm like little doubty McDoubt skins, he's like, if there is one thing I know about you is that you can kick ass and everything you do is awesome. Even if it might be hard at the beginning for you, you always figure it out. And I'm like, okay. Right. So like, that's it. And it's like the last thing I'm going to say on this is, it's like, you know, if you have a cold, right, and your kids need you, you don't just like phone it in. You try to rally, you do as much as you can so that you can still help them. And I feel like that's that same energy is like, listen, you can be down, but don't be out.
Right.
Okay. Whew. We need you. All right. So let's clear that last big chakra. Really root you in. And And this is kind of, I don't know if you do vision boarding, but it's kind of showing me like a new vision board, like a new, like everything is already checked off, lady. Like, let's get a new vision board together.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah.
Do you do vision boards?
I do. And it's true. It's like, I have been in this place of like, well, now what? Because everything that I wanted is checked off. And some of the things that are on there have shifted.
Yes. That's that gratitude card. It's like, give thanks for all you have. Like, you got it.
Yeah.
So like, what else is possible? How does it get better than this?
Right.
Oh, let's open up those possibilities.
Right.
And dance. Dance. Move your body. Like, I don't need to tell you this.
But it's good to hear.
She's the Tai Chi master over here. Like, what am I telling her for? Oh my God. So let's move our body. Let's, and maybe this is a new moon ritual that you do or a full moon. I mean, it's like, I want you to move your body. I want you to cook up something like so yummy and delicious and big and scary. And, it's like allowing that collective energy to come through. Like, what do you need to birth through me? What do you want? What is ready to come out right now? What do you need? And just like really allow that to come through. Also, we're going to just release any of those hidden agendas, hidden fears, any like limiting beliefs or stories that have to do with releasing this membership and what it's supposed to be. Let's just like go all of that crap, like clear the desk. It's a blank slate. You make the rules, and it can be as simple or as complicated as you want it. But for right now, it can just be simple. And simple does not mean that it's not valuable. It's highly valuable. Let's let that in. Good. My stomach just gurgled for you. Check. Great. Pull that in. Let's get all the energy and moving up, down, in, out. Bring those colors in. Bring those sounds in. Everything in harmony. Good. We give great gratitude for all of Rini's guidance, for their work, their wisdom, their messages. We ask that she's always surrounded by the most amazing light of unconditional love, allowing her to be fully expressed in her highest alignment in this lifetime, feeling joy, ease, abundance, flow, grace, trusting in divine timing, divine outcome, trusting in her own divine wisdom, allowing her to expand, to shift, to call in her highest soulmate clients that are ready to do this work with her now. Giving gratitude for all those people who have already said yes, all of those soulmate clients who are already in Rini's field, ready to do this work, to accept this next level, and gratitude for those soulmate clients who are coming, who she's yet to meet, but are on their way to say yes. Who begin following her on social media, who begin joining her email list, who begin subscribing, who begin buying, who begin sharing, who begin referring. Thank you. And allowing those people whose lives have been transformed through Rini's work to then serve at their highest level, to live their best lives through her work, through her teachings. Thank you. And so be it. Fully coming back in to your body, back into your field, present. And when you're ready, you can take a nice long deep breath in. Come back. Deep body stretch. Beautiful.
All sorts of alignment happened when I did that stretch.
Oh, good. Did you pop?
Yep.
Love that. Yep.
Me too.
Good. So, you know, a lot of work came through, especially around being fully expressed and acknowledging the work that you have done to get to this point, really embodying and embracing who you are here and now, who you've become. Giving yourself that space for it to come when it's ready, yeah, as well. You know, you don't have to force or push it out. It's going to be there when it's there. But also don't be afraid to give yourself a date that you are ready for it to show up. And it doesn't have to be a logical, like planned out, executed, whatever it is. Like, just make it so easy. Just make it so easy for yourself and for other people. And making sure that you do that, like movement, dancing practice, really setting those new intentions, those new, for your new vision board. And make sure you stay hydrated, do all the integration work that you know what to do. And that's it. I'll have you check in a couple of weeks after the session, okay, to sort of see how everything is feeling. And what we'll be doing are kind of making it this nice little series where you get to see people's transformation from the session and then a couple of weeks after. So we'll send you information on that, but it's been awesome. Thank you.
Lovely. So healing. Thank you so much. I feel, yeah, it's just so different.
Yeah. The light in the room is different right now
too. Yeah, totally. Yeah, my whole sense of my body is different.
Good.
Yeah.
Enjoy that.
I will. I'm going to go vision board right now.
Whoop, whoop. Ride that energy. Perfect day for,
yeah,
it.
Yeah, totally. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. It's great to see you.
And will I get the recording?
I can give it to you. Yeah.
That would be awesome. I would love that.
I got you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.
Right away after the session that I had with Emily, I felt such a huge shift, like a huge weight had been lifted off my shoulders. I felt total realignment and full clarity on my deepest calling. And since then, I've been powerfully calling it in, and the supports that I've needed have magically come to me immediately. I took action on my next steps for my business. I literally launched my next my membership through Alive and finally had the words to communicate what my healing and magic is so that other people can understand. And that's something I've struggled with for so long. Even my husband commented on the difference in my energy and radiance, and those were his words. There has been so much change and transformation in this month, from speaking out for myself, setting boundaries, visibility on social media, in my business, taking my meditation practice to a whole new level, and all other aspects of my life. Since the launch, I've been enrolling so many more people into my Tune Into Your Celestial Wisdom membership, and I just cannot tell you how grateful I am, Emily, for your healing. Thank you so much.